Well, we just finished up our November Impact Worship event, and we had the privilege of having Stuart Hall with us. And matter of fact, I just shared with him, this was the first time I had the privilege of hearing you speak, but I've heard so much about how God has used you and the ministries that you're a part of and the conferences and things that you do, that it was a great honor to have you here and be a part of what
you guys asked
here.
Me. Thank you.
Well, and tonight, you know, and I know you were talking to students and adults, sure, even through your message tonight, yeah, but I want to let you know from my standpoint that it was a big encouragement to me. Hmm. And I think the challenge not only resonated with me, but I know that it resonated with the middle school and high school students out there to have that courage. Mm-hmm. I think the title is Charge the Train.
Charge the Train.
And why is that, to you, why do you feel like that's important? And what do you see that type of message doing in teenagers' lives today?
Yeah, I didn't really get a chance to talk about the inspiration for the title, but I stumbled on a picture doing some research for a book. It's a picture of a sign in a jungle in Malaysia. And on the sign it says, at this very spot, a bull elephant lost its life after it charged a train in defense of its herd.
Hmm.
And then it had the date. What's interesting is that it was in a jungle, what next to what used to be an active train track.
Wow.
But the train track was no longer active, and the jungle had grown up around the sign.
Wow.
And the story that I read about the sign was that because what wound up happening is that they had built a train through the jungles of Malaysia to move workers back and forth. And in the process of that, a train had hit a couple of baby elephants.
Oh.
And the bull elephant literally stood in the middle of the track and charged the train and literally hit it head on and derailed the train. And at that point, they decided to quit using that track.
Wow.
And it really motivated me to think that I think the missing ingredient in the toolbox of teenage America is bravery.
Mm-hmm.
It's courage. It's all of us, but it's certainly true of students that, you know, incredible leaders like yourself and the youth pastors that, you know, work so hard for students, you know, pour so much incredible truth into their life. And the difference between that truth just kind of laying there and it becoming vibrant in their life is being brave.
Yeah.
Is actually acting on it. So hopefully that connected tonight. That was certainly my intent.
No, I think it did. And again, I think it spoke volumes to me, even the adults. I think that's a message that not only teenagers, but all of us need to hear, to have that courage and to think that what boldness could do.
Sure.
If we do, just like the elephant you're talking about, that's an amazing story. I think that's
right.
I'll take that and sleep on that.
Well, and if you think about it, every one of us have a story where courage stretches to us today. Courage is the determining factor of whether your life, you know, remains circling in a no-win situation or something incredible happens.
Well, thank you so much.
Honored.
And thank all of you guys, especially so many of you guys who support this ministry through your prayers, by bringing students to be a part of these events, by volunteering and by financially supporting events like tonight. And it's an amazing thing to see what God is doing through so many different people. And we invite you guys to be a part of this. Come to our next event coming up in December with our Impact Worship event. And we appreciate so much everything that everyone is doing in any way that they can and what God's called them to do.